Hello friends, today we are going to see about the topic electric circuits. Myself B. Swapna, assistant professor from the department of ECE, Dr. MGR Educational Research Institute, Chennai. We are going to cover the topics are series connection, derive the equation for the series resistance and derive the equation for voltage division rule. So here in this video we are going to see about series connection related topics like calculation of series resistance and voltage division rule. Already in the previous video we saw about series connection. We know that electronic components are connected end to end, that is known as series connection, and make a single path for current flow. In series connection, current will be same, voltage will be different. In series connection, if any damage occur in a single component, then it affect the full circuit. That's the only one disadvantage in series connection. So we are going to see the derive equation for series resistance. So we are taking two resistance, R1 and R2, are connected in series with a battery V. See, this is a series connection circuit diagram. Two resistors are connected in series, R1 and R2, having voltage V1 and V2 respectively. Current starts to flow as I. That current will be same throughout the circuit. In series circuit, already we know that current will be same, voltage will be different. V1 across R1, V2 across R2. Hence, series voltage V is equal to sum of two voltage present at the circuit, V1 plus V2. We are going to mark the equation 1. By Ohm's law, we know that V is equal to I into R. Voltage is equal to current into resistance. Here we are seeing about series connection. Hence, I can mention R as RS. V is equal to I into RS. Similarly, V1 is equal to I into R1. V2 is equal to I into R2. Here current will be same, hence I as it is high. V and R will change as RS, R1, R2, V, V1, V2. And we are going to mark the three equation as number 2. Now substitute equation 2 in equation 1. We know that equation 1 is V is equal to V1 plus V2. Now we are going to substitute equation 2 in equation 1. In the place of V, we are substituting I into RS. V1, I into R1. V2, I into R2. Here, we are taking I as common, then I into R1 plus R2. I gets cancelled, hence we are getting RS is equal to R1 plus R2. This is the equation for series resistance. From the equation number 3, we can define the series resistance as sum of all resistance which are present in the respective circuits, that is known as series resistance. From the equation 3, we can conclude RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 up to Rn. So this is the equation for series resistance. Next topic, derive the equation for voltage division rule. We are going to apply the voltage division rule only for series connection. So here we are taking one series connection with the two number of resistance. Same thing, two resistors are in series. V is a voltage, I is a current. Current will be same. V1 and V2 are the voltage across R1 and R2 respectively. Here we know the Ohm's law, V is equal to I into R. Here I into RS we are mentioning series connection. And we know the formula for series resistance, RS is equal to R1 plus R2. We are going to mark first equation and second equation. Now, substitute equation number 2 in equation 1. In the place of RS, we are substituting R1 plus R2. From this equation, we need the value of I. I is equal to V divided by R1 plus R2. This product goes to that side, means that comes under division. Mark the equation as 3. Next, we know that the Ohm's law, V1 is equal to I into R1, V2 is equal to I into R2. Same thing, current will be same, so we can keep I as I. Now substitute third equation in equation number 4 and 5. So your third equation is V by R1 plus R2. We are going to substitute that equation in this fourth and fifth. So V1 here, in the place of I, we are going to substitute V by R1 plus R2 into R1. Here V1 is equal to, we are keeping V as separate, into R1 by R1 plus R2. Similarly, fifth equation, we are going to substitute the equation 3 in equation 5. Your fifth equation is V2 is equal to I into R2. In the place of I, we are going to substitute V divided by R1 plus R2 into R2. V2 is equal to V into R2 by R1 plus R2. Now, see equation 6 and 7. We are having left hand side V1, here V2, that is unknown voltage. We don't know that voltage, hence it is named as unknown voltage. V is our supply voltage, so we know the value, that is named as known voltage. Here in the equation 6, we are having in the denominator, in the numerator, we are having R1. So here the left hand side we are having V1. So R1 is a resistance, V1 is a voltage across the resistance R1. So here commonly named as same resistance as per unknown voltage. See this equation 7, V2 is equal to V into R2 by R1 plus R2. Here R2 is a resistance, V2 is a voltage across resistance R2. That's why commonly we can say voltage division rule is nothing but unknown voltage is equal to known voltage into same resistance as per unknown voltage divided by sum of all resistance. This is the common formula for voltage division rule. Thank you.